post.
I just tweeted now live.
Get this going so we can see when we're actually live properly. Turn the volume down. Come on, show up. We're up.
Cool.
Hello, peoples.
Hello.
Why is it saying clip is trimming here? That's not good. Okay, I think it's up properly now. Or we've completely broken stuff because the internet's being bad. Whoa. Okay. Hello, folks. So we're going to be playing Seaman to see what happens when he's almost stranded on dry land. And then we're playing through a whole bunch of the Oli Wonder Boy series, which are incredibly convoluted and hard to remember the names of.
Yeah, that'll be interesting.
Like, we're only playing through the main games. That still leaves us with three games that have the number three in them. if you check out the Hardcore Gaming 101 site, you'll see just how convoluted this series is. Didn't get... Oh, cool. Someone streamed your game without getting banned.
That's good. I hope that continues.
These are some of the games also that I grew up with. So, because I was a weird Master System
kid. So
you
can finally find out what is wrong with Miguel Sternberg.
So many things.
Where did it all go wrong?
Switch over to Dreamcast. Why not?
The time setting of the Dreamcast's internal clock does not match the time setting of your Seaman habitat file. The time setting settings...
Whoops. Okay, I probably got the year wrong. whoa, cancel. Just need to see the date on it.
January 18th.
Okay.
2000.
Yeah. No. Settings. That is right?
Yeah.
January
18,
2000.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it's the hour was weird, like it was back in time?
Maybe.
I'll try that out.
For the record, it's only Miguel pulling your games out of his ass. I don't know anything about any of this shit. Except Run Man. That was my weird dark horse. Mm-hmm. But other than that...
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. This is your third visit today. Although your care is appreciated, it is not necessary for you to lavish quite so much attention on Seaman.
Nor does he deserve it.
First, a recap of your previous
research.
Your team effort with the podfish to create dry land was very impressive. Congratulations on a job well done. At the moment, the habitat contains 1 podfish. He is suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level.
Should probably just restart and start next day.
Yeah.
Allow me to give you the highlights for today.
Let me finish the highlights.
The pregnant podfish will soon
what?
Give birth. Make sure you do not miss this dramatic experience. So let us head over to the
top. Well, all right.
Man, the life cycle that just does not stop giving. Horrible nightmares.
I really wish it would stop giving. It could really stand to give a little less.
That cathartic DC disc drive sound.
I'm freezing. Oh, goody. Yay! Oh, goody.
No, no. Adventure Island isn't obscure. Wonder Boy is a whole other matter. As you are going to find out. You'll see. Just trust me on this one.
Well, Adventure Island only does the first game, right? Oh, I guess we don't need to do oxygen now.
Like,
there's a missing thing. Seems like it's doing well. Let's just spray it.
Yeah, I really gotta moisten these moths.
I think it's to keep the plants growing. Good flapping noises. Hi, Seaman. Well, it tickles for you while I drink.
Don't make me laugh. Knock it off.
What is that URL that has...
I don't know.
Clips, Twitch, TV, Spooky Games... The dark on 3, or dark 1 with a 3 as an E.
I believe that should be the dark 3rd.
What is that link? Give both.
Well, what a nice thing to say.
I don't think that's strictly true.
Talk to me, Seaman.
What's up?
Talk to me.
What? Ah, the sweet ground.
It's happening.
Happening.
It's running its face into the wall.
That's probably how evolution works.
I remember this bit in Evo. So it's a clip from one of our previous streams. This reminds me reminds me of a clip of penguins waddling for 2 miles and it caught Planet Earth that I watched last night.
Yeah.
Except Seaman isn't bleeding. Oh, is it? Oh, just the other fin. Whenever anything like interactive like special is happening, you can't pick up an object. Still less terrifying than the sound of actual childbirth. Yeah, my mom was a midwife, I know these things. Yes, we're pretty sure it's giving both. It's probably also dying.
Unfortunately, it doesn't do the courtesy of dying before he gives birth.
Why did it save him in the middle of that? That's just the Seaman way. Oh man, games before mapping. Look at that shimmer. I there's certain aspects of Seaman that are just, their commitment to the bit is just really impressive. So like when we watched the first caterpillar turn into a moth and can't climb out. It took like 2 or 3 minutes for it to get out, at least.
This scene is why the voice actors are on strike.
Oh.
It's happening.
Oh, of course. Forgot that it doesn't have a cloaca, instead it has like a weird genital tube. So those eggs just like the original eggs? It looks like it. Oh no! It has teeny little tadpole.
Well, I think it's time for me to leave you. Goodbye, friend.
Circle of life. Grab these? No. Huh. I guess we should check in tomorrow?
Did.
Now we're gonna check in tomorrow. May we all leave this world with as much dignity as Seaman.
Wonder if they're gonna eat the body for food.
Yeah, I keep wondering if it's going to do that. They kind of did that bit already in the first bit with the Nautilus.
That's true.
You start to forget just the level of weird shit Seaman has put us through. Do you put the tadpoles in the water? I tried and it wouldn't let me pick them up. So it looks let's move forward to the next day. Oops, wrong spot. Oh, that's a good name for it. It's Genticle. Talk to us, Nimoy.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. This is your fourth visit today. You visit often. If one didn't know better, one might assume you're quite obsessed.
I always get that wrong. Turns out Death Stranding is a prequel to Seaman. There's a collaboration I'd like to see.
Great, can Del Toro just steal these babies so we don't have to deal with them?
Oh man, I now want to see someone
Hello.
Photoshop in Seaman.
Welcome
no,
to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. Let's see. Last time, the podfish emerged onto dry land to lay eggs. However, it expired immediately afterwards. Take good care of the hatchlings, as an important life was sacrificed to create them. Allow me to give you the highlight for today. It is about time for the eggs to hatch. Pay close attention to what emerges. So let us head over to the tank.
Even Nimoy sounds so cheerful about Seaman's death. I'd be happy about it too, but I know it just portends even worse things. If Seaman has taught us anything,
it's all bad, all the way down. Happening. I feel like the Dreamcast is just slowing down. Right?
long. Is there a spider there?
Yeah, but there's
a spider
there. Well, this is gonna be a problem.
Well, they aren't eating right now, so this might be the best time to get rid of it.
Yeah.
Does it have semen? Oh, that's some other sort of face.
Yeah, it's...
Ugh.
I don't like it.
Please don't eat the eggs.
No, there's no oxygen anymore. You don't have control of it since, you know, there's nowhere for it. It's just air.
So essentially, we don't want Seaman to ever eat the spider because it makes Seaman sick. So I'm hoping by throwing it in now when there's nothing.
How are you supposed to kill it normally?
It drowns. Like, you feed Seaman, and then you put it in.
I see.
The water sort of drowns. Whoa. That's a new type.
Yeah. That's probably not a spider, because...
No, I think it might be... Maybe it's a butterfly? Because, yeah, that's what the moth ones look like.
Yeah. Well, we'll find out.
Yeah. What's happening over here in Eggland? Come on, Hatchy Hatchy.
Might need to get a certain temperature.
I'm not sure what, like, is that? That feels like optimal hatching lighting. Close to the top of the temperature thing, and like the colors haven't changed that it uses.
I thought it was supposed to be like 19.
That's optimal, but like anything in the yellow.
I thought it was supposed to be like in blue that was. What was that?
I feel like it'll go red if I do much more.
Huh.
Yeah, maybe it has changed and I put it too hot?
I don't think so.
I feel like Nimoy would have told us if it needed to be a different temperature.
Yeah.
Maybe I think I've put it too hot. Let's check in tomorrow.
Does it feel too hot?
Come on, little weird things. What's this spider gotten to? Yeah.
You can't, like, drop into the water, can you?
I don't think so. I still didn't even get closer to it because I want to get a better look at its weird face. Yeah, I can't even grab it now. Hopefully with nothing to eat, it'll die soon. going on with you guys?
I need to turn the temperature up.
How high?
24.
Okay.
I don't know if that'll trigger it, but...
But that's now their ideal temperature.
Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah. You're right, it's what needed to be the blue zone. Oh yeah, because it goes red if it's past the blue zone. 20 what?
24.9. I'm sure it's 24.7.
Yeah. Not like I have control over the points, given... It'll cool down to that in a second. There you go, nice and warm little creepy things. Oh, huh. It goes to like a blue phase.
Okay.
Interesting.
You can move some rocks, right?
Yeah, I can move the small ones at least, I think. Oh, yeah.
Where's the spider?
There.
Yeah, it might work.
Don't think so, because I move them really slowly. And only side to side, really.
Well, maybe one of them will eat the spider and die.
Such is life.
It's fine, there's a lot of them.
Hi, Seaman. Why does everything have a human face in this goddamn game? Do you remember that the human face is the face of the creator of the game?
It's a very specific face.
Very special, hateable face. Should we check in tomorrow?
It should really only be 5 minutes.
Okay.
I'm not sure why it's...
Oh, maybe because we didn't have to heat it at the optimal.
Oh, fuck.
Let's chat up to boil them all. I feel like that manga genre, but that isn't a manga, that's a genre. We should pull up the Wonder Boy stuff and talk about some of the historical stuff with that while we're waiting for these to hatch.
We're saving, maybe.
Maybe this is it.
Maybe this is the one.
Is it the moment of truth?
It does not appear to be the moment of truth.
Rotating little fuckers.
Doesn't seem like it corresponds to...
What is it saying that happened?
Like, it doesn't seem to be... It suggests it'll happen.
Okay.
Like...
Oh, I wonder if there's some way to... They're still getting stuck in the spider's web. So, a way for me to... Oh! I can save them from the spider's web. What's that noise? Or is that something? God damn it! Oh yeah, it's just this one eating. That's what we're hearing.
really wish they'd just stopped. Can you grab the spider web? They really have a problem.
Yeah, death wish there.
I think whenever it's empty, they just fly towards it.
Yeah, I don't think we will clear it out. It probably just takes like a day. Whoa! I guess they hatched.
Hello? Are you
Hello.
Listening?
You probably find them on the screen.
Hello. Hello. Okay, recognize that. Waiting. Tickles. Can I pick this up?
Stop it. Let me go. What are you doing?
Bigger than I expected.
Let me go, you jerk. Masher.
Hello.
Yo. Stop it. Stop it.
Gotta
stop
keep him happy.
It. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Hello, Seaman.
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
Tell me about Sega.
Hello.
Hello.
They're probably hungry.
Yeah.
This better be important. I was wondering, how is your health these days?
Amazing.
Oh well, we'll try again later.
Recognize. Talk to me, Seaman.
Coming, Your Majesty.
Talk to me.
This better be good. It's really not a difficult question. I said, I was wondering, how is your health these days?
Good.
You feel all right, do you?
Yes.
I thought you just
I
said
hate
you felt
it when
great.
It...
Look, if you're just going to mess with me, I'll have to remember not to give a crap about you. Let's try this
Wait, that,
again.
That implies
how do you feel?
Good.
You feel all right, do you?
Yes.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. You know how I worry.
No, I don't, actually.
Yeah, the seamen have genetic memory, so all the seamen are one consciousness.
Hey, go tickle yourself. I'm busy.
Talk to me.
What can I do for you?
Hello.
Just wait. It always has sort of like an intro, and then it'll go into its speech thing, if it has something to say. Maybe not.
Don't make me laugh.
They'll all come just below. Are you trying to hypnotize them?
Hello. Talk to me.
Yeah, see if there's some food that they need. I don't know if they eat yet.
Yeah, they do.
Let's see what we got in terms of foods.
Yeah, we got.
There's a caterpillar. That's good enough.
Wait. Seriously?
Maybe we don't... Can we pick it up again? Maybe we don't feed them until they get up on land.
Maybe. Shit.
I can hang out with the spider we put. It's in some sort of bizarre loop. Shall we leave it till tomorrow?
Ask more questions. Talk to me. Talk to me. Hello, Seaman.
What?
No, you might be about to.
Talk to me. Seaman.
Oh, hey, that one just did a jump out of the water.
Say it with me, Seaman. One more time. Seaman. Seaman. Good, I knew you could get it.
Seaman. Seaman.
You're just making fun of you.
It's plausible. And it keeps doing that. Talk to me.
Walt's loudest caterpillar.
Can I help you?
Yes.
It'll cost you a buck.
Fine.
So... You feel pretty good,
so for that
huh?
Weird sound in my
well,
ear.
That's great, but being the moon child that you are, I'll bet you probably take your health for granted sometimes. Is that true?
Yes.
I thought so. As long as I've been around, you soft little creatures, you never seem to know how good you have it.
Stopped. Oh, thank God. That was a caterpillar glitching.
Hello.
Oh no! I think it's...
I'm gonna pee if you don't stop.
I think it's trying to eat the ground.
Oh my god.
Hey, go tickle yourself. I'm busy.
Busy with what?
Not much, just keeping it real.
How real?
Whoa, keep it down.
Okay, I think we should take Mr. Caterpillar as a sign.
Talk to me.
Would you like to save and end
Let's
the session?
Stop the racket. Seaman is annoyed at the friggin' caterpillar.
It's every button and start?
Yeah, every button and start is the Control-Alt-Delete of the Dreamcast. I don't think did the PS1 or PS2 have any sort of equivalent key combination?
No, but they took that from Nintendo, which had it on the Game Boy.
Okay.
Because there's no hardware reset button.
Mm-hmm.
It was that, except also select.
But that didn't have like an OS at the bot base like
no,
this does.
It was just built into like every game.
Yeah.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. First, a recap of your previous visit. The eggs have hatched, and new creatures emerged. Due to their appearance, we will call them Cadmen. At the moment, the habitat contains 6 Cadmen. They are suffering from the cold. Please use the heaters to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
I do like that it kind of trolled us into thinking that, like, oh, he's just going to transform into the Seaman because
yeah.
Now he's up on land. It's like, nope, there's a whole other life cycle. Also, like, how many different separate bodies is it inhabited now in this entire thing?
A lot.
I feel like we're up to, like, a dozen.
Oh, the spiderweb's gone now.
Ah, good. So, yeah, throw some water down on here. It's just, up on the D-pad.
I feel like we're getting some real slowdown.
Yeah, I was definitely having some weirdness with that.
How about turning up the heat? Oh, goody. Yay! It's about time. Yay! Oh, goody. It's about time. Oh, goody.
They make little jumps.
It's about time.
Yeah.
That's the only cute thing they've ever done.
No.
Pretty much.
Come on. It's about time.
Did you get pissed off because you stopped adding heat?
Yeah.
Heat.
No, annoying.
Oh, come in.
Hey,
wants
you.
To talk to us.
Hello.
Saying hello again.
Hello.
Yeah. Hello. Whatever.
Jeez.
Sup.
Word.
I was just gonna ask, I wasn't sure if that was actually a thing yet.
So as I was saying before, you humans haven't always had it so easy. Picture this. Ancient Egypt, 5,000 years ago, There's no heat, no cold medicine, nothing. It's just you against the elements. Imagine if you had gotten sick then. Hey, are you listening to me?
Yes.
Oh, good. You might
bitch,
actually
you're the one
learn
who needs
something
the heat.
Then.
We're doing just fine. Everything, but especially the heater.
It doesn't need to be perfect.
Yeah, I just... Can you go away?
It'll just fade away, I think, when you're not doing anything like that.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. I'm gonna pee if you don't stop.
Talk to me.
I don't want to.
I think let's call it for a week.
There's supposed to be more things it says.
Yeah.
Quit it. Quit it. It hurts.
We'll get to them eventually. It's just sometimes temperamental. Give it another go?
I was supposed to do it like this day.
Mm. I sound like Santa.
I think it's coming up to talk to us. To get this gin soaked strawberry. Well.
Hello. Yo.
Quiet.
It's in a bad mood.
Yeah.
What? Oh, knock it off. Oh, 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 oh. Don't make me laugh. Don't make me laugh.
Just hit once. Because it works, I think, like a toggle. So if you do a bunch of hits, sometimes it toggles them on and off from looking at you. I think these ones just may not be hypnotizable.
I think they keep looking away every time I try.
Yeah, no, which makes me think they might not be supposed to be hypnotizable. The time of hypnotizing the seamen is gone. Try talking one more time and see.
Seaman, what's good? Tell me about Egypt.
Hello.
There you go. Say hello.
Hello.
Hey, if you want some action, rent a movie and lock the door.
Huh.
No.
You can tell your friends to stop hitting on me.
I think you said ho.
Would you like to save and end the
Surely
session?
Surely not.
I don't know. Should we see Seaman vocabulary expanded in his new form? I mean, for the random stuff he says. Like, I don't remember him commenting that he sounds like Santa after laughing. Yeah, no, I think each time it changes form, it understands more things.
Well, like, and he's talking about keeping it real.
Yeah. It definitely does expand, which is tricky because I keep on trying to say things that I remember working, but I think they worked at like a specific point. But yeah, let's switch over to the first Wonder Boy. one sec. Make this big while I switch this. And Elgato settings. Turn off the Dreamcast this time because we forgot to do that last time.
And you just hear it the whole time.
Yeah. It just becomes sort of like white noise, really loud white noise. Oh, we need to exit and put it into the first Wonder Boy. Choose a Wonder Boy, yeah.
Yeah, in space.
Oh, Jesus. Well, that's definitely a list of different games with almost the same name. Okay, that's done.
You
update
set
changed.
To mode?
Oh, it's still not showing up on the the screen here.
Oh.
Go into Wonder Boy itself and I'll mess with things until it shows up. Should be HDMI. Should be standard.
So Wonder Boy is on basically every console under the sun. It was originally, what was the original release?
It was originally an arcade game. And so like I actually played it in the arcade and it was the reason I picked up a Master System.
Yeah.
Well, asked for one for Christmas as a kid. Now not
so the version that's on the Wii is the Master System version. There were many, many ports. There was a, like, it was ported to everything, which is actually pretty unusual for a Japanese game. There was an MSX version, a Commodore 64 version, a ZX Spectrum version, which looks like absolute garbage.
This is actually very close in terms of how it looks to how it looked in the arcade. It's a pretty close port. In general, the Master System had like less palette restrictions than the NES, so you get stuff that looks a little bit closer to what was in the arcades at the time.
And probably you know this game as Adventure Island for the NES,
which I think they had like a Japanese celebrity or something is the character in it. They changed it to. Check the details on this because it's too super weird. Oh, so the high jump being linked to running is specific to the Master Systems. So that was a change. So you don't want to get the handbags; those will get you out of this area. So these secret areas are things that were not in the arcade.
Also are completely, I don't understand.
They're a good chance to get your hearts up. So you can get your, there's a stamina bar, instead of having lives, you've got a stamina bar and a single life. So if you're hit by an enemy, it kills you. But if you bump into something like a rock, it lowers your stamina. And eating food ups your points and ups your stamina.
Stamina being the yellow, or the red.
Yeah.
And the bar at the top.
Which, weirdly, I realize is basically how Russian Subway Dogs works, and I'm not sure if that is, like, weird deep subconscious playing this a ton when I was a kid, or just that it makes sense.
You can kill rocks with your invincibility-ness.
of course. I'm trying to find out okay. So yeah, they changed the character's name to Master Higgins in the Adventure Island one.
Chat's saying it was Takashi Meijin.
Okay.
A celebrity gamer who worked at Hudson, who ended up getting his own cartoon show.
Yeah, I think he was famous for being able to push buttons really quickly. Japan celebrity culture is strange. So in terms of the design, something that's interesting about this is it was designed to be sort of played like an infinite runner originally, so it would auto-scroll, and they took that bit out, but you can really see it in the level design, that it's much less about sort of exploring and maybe going backwards some of the time than Mario, which is pretty much contemporary with Super Mario Bros., the first one. So it's much more about constantly moving forward, especially since you're slowly losing stamina at all times. And then, have you gotten the skateboard yet?
No, not yet.
The skateboard basically tones it into...
you can't move backwards at all.
It's
like, you can walk backwards, but you can't, like, go past the screen. It's very,
Shit! If you jump on top of it, it has a different bounce.
Okay, good to know.
Could hit a button 16 times a second. Our chat knows the weird history stuff better than
I do.
You
want to talk about the flickering?
Oh yeah, so a common thing with a lot of old video game hardware is that it can only have so many sprites, so many moving objects on a vertical line or horizontal line.
This is having a lot more problems than an NES game would.
I think it's partially because everything's pretty big on it, so they're using multiple sprites.
Yeah.
Which never helps for flickering.
Okay, I just want to show something that's really infuriating. So this is what happens if you jump normally. It's really tiny. This is what happens if you jump when you're holding down run. I'm not moving. Normal jump, holding run. Normal jump. Holding run.
It does mean you have digital control over it. You can be like, do I want to do a big jump or a small jump?
Okay, but counterpoint. It's really stupid. That's not how running...
Yeah, but video game jumping is always a weird abstraction, is what I would say.
Also, it is the worst jump animation I've ever seen. Sticking my leg yet real far.
Hey, whatever works. Yeah, I was gonna say, all of the games we're playing, this week, and almost all of the games in sort of the main branch of Wonder Boy, which is already, as you'll see, pretty convoluted. We're only playing sort of the canon of Wonder Boy, and it's gonna get strange. What's his name? I'm probably gonna butcher this name, but Ryuichi Nishizawa.
Uncomfortably racist enemies.
Yeah. He made almost all except for one of the games we're gonna play over the next two streams. Which I hadn't realized. I had assumed it was different people doing them because they're such different games. And it's kind of interesting to realize that there was one person behind a bunch of these games that I played throughout my childhood. You definitely will see him get better at making games as these go forward. I think both is like, generally, like, the world got better at making games. Like, we started to figure out what worked. But I think also, like, these go from being sort of, like, pretty competent for the time to, by the time we get to Monster World for... Wonder Boy 5? 6.
Pretty competent for the time is a strong statement for this.
It really is. Like, you have to remember that Super Mario Brothers was the best platformer at the time. Most platformers being done at, like, roughly the same year it came out were far worse than Wonder Boy was. Yeah, no, it's actually, it's weird because it's part of the Monster World game. Sorry, I'm answering somebody saying Monster World 4 is technically not a Wonder Boy game since you don't play as a Wonder Boy. It's weird because, yeah, it's numbered based on its Monster World aspect,
so
but
ugly.
Not its Wonder Boy aspect, even though they're the same series. But only some Wonder Boys are Monster Worlds and only some Monster Worlds are Wonder Boys. That makes sense. So you want to do pass back and forth now?
Yeah, sure. I'll just die here.
The other thing is, like, this was designed to be an arcade game, unlike, I don't think Super Mario Brothers, like, there were arcade
versions. There was
of
a
it.
Version, but it was not designed that way.
Yeah, well, this is very clearly, it has a score. It's a lot less exploration-based and a lot more linear-based. And I'm forgetting what the keys are. There we go. The other thing that's weird is, like, the gameplay changes a lot. Versions of these bats exist throughout the entire series, pretty much. And there's a few other enemies that just, like, come back. And you'll see visual motifs come back, even when the gameplay is really different.
We're using the Wii Classic Controller, and no, arcade games were generally considered to be much better than any home port. Skateboarding!
Yes. So yeah, at this point it becomes, like, Cannibalt. Only Cannibalt. And if you get good with this, you can get through multiple levels while holding onto the skateboard. It also functions as an extra life. Don't want that, because I think it's a death one, which basically drains your... No, that one's a death one. That drains my stamina faster. So I've got to really make sure I eat everything I can. Oh.
I do think the one noticeable thing is that, as far as, like, being arcade difficult goes, this is not a very good example of it. You can go pretty far without. So...
Yeah, both games are really fair for arcade games. They're not like a lot of the Neo Geo games, which look great,
Neo Geo,
but play fucking terrible.
They had a very specific, if you read the technical manual for the developer's guide for making a Neo Geo game, they're very explicit. You should be charging the player every 2 minutes. That is, you should kill the player every 2 minutes, such that they have to put in more money. So, I mean, not just killing them because, you know, like, you probably have, like, 3 lives, so you should be killing a player a third of every 2 minutes, such that they need to put in money.
So you can see the we've gotten the second song that exists of the 2 songs that are in the game. I might be exaggerating, but I'm not exaggerating much. Which means that we're on a boss. There's a boss at the end of every 4 levels, which I guess is the same as...
Same as Mario.
Yeah. Could someone in chat check when Super Mario Brothers' first version came out, when the first version of this came out?
Super Mario Brothers would have been 1985. This was...
There's an example of, like, how momentum is built into the game. That frog character, if I stop at the distance that my tomahawks would hit, or my stone axes, whatever they are, I'd get jumped on by it. But if I keep running, it actually runs right over me.
I got some bad news for you. This is a year after Super Mario Brothers.
It still, though, puts it like it's a reaction just after.
Yep.
Shit. Momentum.
I don't give a fuck.
You can go under them safely as well. Milk is just full stamina.
I have full stamina?
Yep.
Oh, is...
It's basically... Oh, that's part of a bonus system where there's hidden Segas that appear.
Oh, I thought the red part was, like, how much was full, but it's actually just...
No, that's your in danger zone.
Fuck.
Which you're about to be in. So again, there, if you've been running up to that and had some momentum, you'd be fine.
Well, I tried using the spring, but it wasn't...
Yeah. But no, you need the spring and some momentum to be able to make it over.
Shit.
Which is, yeah, what I'm saying, sort of, it's the goal behind the design is very different than Mario's.
Extremely.
It's in some ways like a precursor to Sonic in being more about moving forward than exploring.
Yeah.
Yay, smaller hitboxes than the sprites. Okay, so we're about to come up with one of the other momentum-based things. That red flower signals that badger is going to come by. Sometimes they jump, sometimes they don't. I thought that was one of the ones where it wasn't going to jump, but was going to jump. So you learn to sort of, when you see the red flower, expect a running badger creature coming from behind.
Okay. Which one is Pac-Land?
Pac-Land is the first Pac-Man platformer. The same corner store that had this later had Pac-Land at it near my house growing up. Yeah, no, Pac-Land also seems like it was similar to this from what I remember, in that it was sort of larger sprites, less detailed environments in terms of what you could actually interact with.
Fuck.
Hey, get those bananas, you're low.
It's really hard to see them up there.
Yeah.
Did the fruits also go away in time?
We can do this. I didn't realize that Pac-Land was older, because I think it showed up at that corner store later. Which is sort of funny thing at that time, is like, you didn't really get a sense of when things were made, because one, they'd have to come over from Japan, and two, like, it was just sort of random what showed up where and when. Like, that sense of when, of a straight progression at the time just wasn't there.
Yeah, I mean, you'd only know, like, when release dates were, like, if you were reading magazines, basically. But even though,
and
no,
magazines didn't really exist at this point.
Well, they existed. There were a lot of magazines that existed, but they weren't like, it wasn't as big as like in the 90s. There was like a lot of consolidation.
Yeah, no. I think at this time, like honestly, I don't know if I'd seen a video game magazine yet. I do remember sort of later in the Sega life cycle going to video game stores and they'd have a sheet of like the games that were coming up. Because I remember being obsessed for like 6 months about Phantasy Star coming out. Because the screenshots from that were insane at the time.
Oh,
Okay, so watch out for Mr. Badger. As soon as the flower disappears. Ah, if you jump, he jumps. That's the rule.
Ah.
He jumps higher. Also sloped ground, which is a bit of a tech achievement at the time.
Yeah. You definitely ain't seen that in the Mario game.
You need to hit him in the head.
It's really unresponsive.
Yeah, no, it's getting...
Man, this is some real slowdown, too.
Oh. It should, because, yeah, there's no way to beat the boss without a hammer. Yeah. I don't know what it is, like, before I was...
Yeah, you had it fucking down.
I guess that I used to play it this way. What if I'd play better with the, What I need is a Master System controller with its weird square pad.
Nobody needs that.
So each time you beat the boss, it gets a new head. And since there's like a ridiculous number of levels in this, there's a ridiculous number of different animal heads they put in. I don't know what the mushroom does. I think it might reduce my... I do wonder if there's like a micro bit more lag when we put it through the Elgato, because if it's that or if it's just the fact that we're streaming, so I'm automatically playing worse. Oh, secret fries.
It doesn't feel like time is off.
Yeah, no, it doesn't feel that way to me. I'm just, like, suddenly playing...
Yeah.
Just a little bit worse. Slow down!
Yeah.
It was a very early Master System game. So I feel like it's particularly bad when it comes to that stuff. So you can see the flickering going through both Wonder Boy and the cloud. It's actually kind of a trick you could use in a lot of old games where you could know something was gonna move. Shit. Had to just keep the momentum going. You could know that something was a trap because it was flickering before you touched it. Because clearly it wasn't actually made with tiles, because if it was made with tiles it wouldn't flicker.
Of course not that you know the technical reason for that.
Four levels per area, 10 areas, 2 secret. The 2 secret were added to the Master System version. There's like close to 50 levels.
It's just definitely extremely noticeable to me that this is probably as much flickering as like the later Mega Man games have. And, like, though they were pushing it with a lot more sprites, it's definitely noticeable that, like, the NES could just handle a lot more.
Yeah, on the other hand, its palette restrictions are also severely worse.
Not that this game is making great use of that.
I feel like, there's some pretty decent pixel art in this game for the time.
I feel like that's a very strong statement. I don't know, I'm just thinking about that, like, that cave, which was hideous.
There's some stuff that is too busy.
This flickering would be a lot less noticeable on a CRT. It was still noticeable, like, you could still see it, but not nearly to such an extent. Like, it was definitely something that stood out as jarring.
Yeah, it was definitely something that
you could tell.
You could use it as a tool. As I said, I did do that.
The one thing is that it didn't, is that it's really uneven here. Like, you can only see, like parts of things flickering out, which is not something I ever experienced on the NES.
I think this would, did do parts even on, old stuff, because I think it's, like, different sprites coming into.
That's the thing, like
those
not,
swordfish
not
are the worst.
They're once.
Really, like, memory-based. Oh, I think the moving clouds also have a light blue below them compared to a dark blue for that last line. But yeah, color-wise, almost nothing in this game would work on an NES. Like, even some of the simple-looking things have more colors or more shades. Basically, in an NES...
And then you get to this level and it's like, it doesn't even matter.
On an NES, you could get three colors per sprite. And anytime you see more than that, like in Super Mario Bros. 3, it's because they're using multiple sprites over top of each other or on top of each other.
I think in Super Mario Bros. 3 it was actually, they actually didn't use that trick.
I think it's still,
they use different sprites and they're bigger and, like, they're coloring different things.
Yeah, no, what I mean is that they put two, not over top of each other, like, directly over top of each other, one on top of the other, like, height-wise. The top of the sprite versus the bottom of the sprite.
I'm not sure I'll tell you.
Yeah, it's been a while since I looked at them, but that was sort of the common sort of tricks to deal with the really severe limitation in colors.
Definitely, like, Mega Man is, like, the big example of...
Getting that. Starting to get it back. Oh, fuck off.
So it sounds like what Capcom did, and probably a lot of other developers did, was they would flicker the sprites out. Like they would switch the sprite out rather than letting the hardware flicker it, since that way they can do the entire object rather than what the hardware has arbitrarily decided
and immediately died. I want what the doll's wearing. That's a cool outfit.
Oh, do you want to talk about diagonal scrolling?
Diagonal scrolling? In what way?
Can you scroll in two directions here?
I think possibly in the stair step things, but I don't know if I actually have seen any. Alex Kidd, which was the other sort of big mascot for Master System games, did have some bits that went, like, down or sideways.
So that's something that you couldn't do on the NES. It wasn't capable of scrolling in, you can only do one direction at a time. Ah, yeah!
Yeah, there, just a diagonal there. Yeah.
Yeah, so that would be completely impossible on,
And all the weird, like, I've been realizing this going back to these old Master System games, there's all these strange things that all they really do is just give you, like, more points, like those glasses that just showed up. And as a kid, there'd be these, like, weird mysteries. Like, why did that show up only there? And, like, what does it mean? Did I get some sort of special power?
Nope, it's just more points, which don't mean anything.
That's sort of like this weird transitional period between, arcade score games and games made for consoles. And computer games.
Oh, and like the slope shots, multi-directional scrolling too.
Oh yeah. So that's something the NES couldn't do.
Nope. Some games did, but that was because they had a chip inside the cartridge. Which is like definitely a weird thing that you could do on cartridge-based systems. You could just include extra chips, and like it would be expensive.
Oof.
Because they. Oh, that was fine.
Yep. But that was definitely a little last fuck you at the bottom of that.
Yeah, no, it's real ugly. Like, some famous examples of that is like Star Fox has the Super FX chip inside, which lets it do 3D.
I don't know if the Master System ever did that. What it did have was it also had card games, games that were on thin cards, and it had a card slot, and those games were always terrible. They were basically like, if you look at the really early NES games, like, they were basically those level of games for the Master System, so you always knew that if it came on a card, it was going to be kind of shit. Like, to a higher level than a lot of Red Flower. A lot of, just the general level of bullshit you expected from NES and Master System games. It was like a whole other level. Because there just wasn't a lot of memory on them.
Star Fox was, mid-90s, 1993. But you saw it on, NES games, too. There is, I believe it's Castlevania 3, which includes, a chip that gives it an extra sound channel, which actually sounds incredibly different than most NES games, because, it basically, like, it sounds like it actually has chords. Which is not something you would ever hear on the on normal.
This game is definitely like some of the worst music on the Master System. Despite the fact that I obsessively learned how to play the main thing on the piano, which is very easy. Golvelius is a game that has some really great sound on the system. And is also a Zelda-type game with auto-scrolling, top-down levels.
Extra Sand Channel was only on the, could only work on the Famicom because, they moved the pins on the NES.
Okay, I've heard about that one then.
Yeah.
It was, like, a difference between
Famicom version. It had different audio here. I assumed it was just for price reasons, but that makes sense.
Okay, let's see how long I can keep the skateboard. I do really like the thing of trying to keep the skateboard from multiple levels. So you can get through them much faster. Damn. Oh, but that was secret. Oh, I wonder if I had to destroy that rock to get the doll in this level.
Oh.
Oops.
We want to move on to...
I think we'll move on soon. I was going to say Alex Kidd in Miracle World, the first one, sort of doubles down on the skateboard thing in that it has like a whole bunch of different vehicles. A helicopter, a motorcycle.
Alex Kidd is like incomprehensible.
It's pretty strange. I'm just so glad that I now know that the exits in it are on a gear. Yeah, they're a watch. Why... Oh! The glasses were... It's all, like, her stuff.
Oh. Well, that makes sense. That is in no way inexplicable at all.
It's more explicable than, like, why did sunglasses only appear on that stage? Like, not much more. frogs take two shots at what? That's why it turned red. Oh, nice. Oh, fuck you.
I don't see how that was nice.
I like that they put two of those in a row like that. And you just bounce along them. It's the only 8-bit version of a ridiculous loop in Sonic. Hey, there were simpler times.
I mean, there was a Master System Sonic.
Yeah, but that was at that point.
It was, yeah.
Yeah, that was one of those weird...
A Sega... Except for a few games, didn't they? Where they ported Genesis games back to the back to the Master System?
Yeah,
which
no,
is so weird, because meanwhile...
I think you can also play Golden Axe on the Master System.
Not only did that not happen for Super Nintendo games, but, like, NES games that were released after Super Nintendo
came out
suffered.
So as soon as I die, we can switch off.
Okay.
Oh, fuck! Those guys. Yeah. No, they do continually, like, introduce new enemies. And there's this weird series of levels that look like giant teeth.
I'm really angry that rock doesn't animate. Like, it doesn't roll.
Yeah.
It just slides. Really choppy scrolling.
Hey, it's scrolling diagonally while I'm on a skateboard.
Wow, that's extremely radical, dude.
Without blast processing, I'll add. Got the doll. I think you needed to collect all the dolls to open up some of the extras or something, like bonus stuff. I can't remember what the deal was exactly.
Are they... This game's Chaos Emeralds?
They might be.
Oh, now I can kill the fire. Because that makes sense. Fairy kills rocks.
Okay, so there's three songs. There's the victory song, the regular level song, and the final stage song. Oh shit. You sort of get good at this of like letting go of the run button just to like throw.
Oh yeah, the dolls are the Chaos Emeralds. You need them to get into area 9 and 10.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I did that once.
So even then. Design.
I think I may have done it.
In Sega published game was terrible.
Oof, slow down. Now I don't know if the slowdown was that bad on the actual hardware.
I'd be very surprised if it was introduced in emulation.
Yeah, no, me too. Yeah, that move, the, like, jumping backwards while ripping tomahawks. Oh.
Oh, that doesn't even matter.
I want to get him, though. Oh.
That is some brutal slowdown.
Yeah. Yep, starting to get my skills back. Good thing we're about to switch to another.
I'm glad your muscle memory has returned just in time to...
Yeah, switch games. There. I'll switch what we're playing. So, in between this game and the next game, the designer played Wizardry. But he was still
to
making
fair,
arcade.
Everyone in Japan played Wizardry.
Yeah,
Wizardry was inexplicably huge. I've never heard anyone adequately explain why this happened, but...
Okay, I need to see what, which one this is, because it doesn't have a number on Twitch. Monsterland, okay. Reset it to the beginning.
So you want to talk about the Monster World series?
This is the start of the Monster World series, which is part of the Wonder Boy series some of the time, and vice versa. He played Wizardry and decided he wanted to make an RPG, but he was still making an arcade game. So this is an action RPG with a side quest that you play in a single sitting in an arcade. Filled with secrets. Totally different attack style.
Really, just absolutely nothing in common with...
Also, lots of bars where you can buy drinks.
Is there a reason to?
They sometimes get secrets, and sometimes you'll find out about the relationships the different ones have with each other.
Okay, I don't care about secrets. I care about armor. Do you want to talk about the timer?
Okay, yeah. So,
fuck.
Continuing the sort of thing of like it being still momentum based while also being an RPG, the hourglass timer up in the corner.
Damn it.
It ticks down. When it finishes ticking down, it starts ticking down your life. Which means you can die from just taking too long on a stage. It also, though, changes how many points you get when you finish the level, because it has points, not experience. All of your leveling up is done Monster Hunter style, where you have to level up your equipment. So those will speed you up if you get better boots.
And also changes your sprite.
Yep. Yeah, it actually has like full like paper dolling for the different outfits and stuff. This is for the magic system.
Do I want bombs?
Yeah, you could. You push down on the D-pad to use them. Because remember, the master system had two buttons.
Yeah.
And you just sort of toss them ahead of you. So you don't have a shield yet, which means you've got to dodge these. Also, jumping in certain spots will cause coins to appear.
Just secret coins?
Yeah. A lot of the game is sort of learning all the little secrets and memorizing them so you can get better equipment. But you can totally get through without good equipment. And the bats are back, with like slight modification to their AI.
Oh, it just told us about a secret behind the wall.
Yeah. A neat thing it does is it, like, first it does this, then it'll, like, do something subtler, and eventually gives you no hints. And it's just about sort of learning how the level designer thinks. The speedrun for this game was tied today, and then the guy kept playing for 8 hours more trying to beat it. See how someone who's never played, how far you'll get. I'll of course play worse than usual, because that's always what happens.
Oh.
So this was actually a case of an optional boss, some of which are secret, like you only have to find them if you like press behind the blank area. But it got you a better sword. So I imagine speedrunners probably skip some of the optional bosses.
What's H?
It's a hospital. You can pay to get healed.
I'm feeling okay. Oh shit, I should really...
Yeah. Oh.
Fuck! Well, I'm gonna die.
No, you almost hit the end. Chat was asking whether the character disappears when you get hit, and no, we're flickering on our end. So yeah, you'll probably get seeing weirder flickers on the stream.
Just in this one, the flickers in the last one were really intense.
You can do it, you can do it. There's a boss after this, but you can do it. Oh, you had an item, I think, that healed you.
Well, that's good, because... So when you grab the key, all the coins disappear, so you have to grab the coins first, then?
Yeah. There's a lot of sort of those weird early arcade... Yeah, the TurboGrafx 16 version, somebody's mentioning it, was completely different. I think that's the Dynastic Hero one, where everyone's in bug suits. A lot of these games, if you played them in Brazil, starred Monica, who is like a popular cartoon or comic character there. I have vague memories from living in Brazil when I was 10 for a year of that character. But it's totally like, it would be like going like, oh yeah, this stars the characters from Family Circus for some reason.
Oh, you can actually kill them.
Yeah.
I was just not doing a very good job at it. Do I want
to
get
a... you don't need to get a drink. I don't know if it heals you at all, getting drinks. I don't think it does. I haven't really paid attention. And this is a game I didn't own, but a good friend of mine who also had a Master System, had, so I played a ton at his house. Enough that I remember where a lot of the dumb secrets are. I feel like there's a secret having to do with that moving platform there. I think you can get something here. What is it? Some shield chop? Oh. Fireballs or mystery spell. You're gonna get a chance to buy a shield soon, so I wouldn't buy anything
here. Yeah, shield sounds great.
Yeah, worth checking, because that's where they'll start sticking secrets. Oh, heart.
Oh shit, I'm out of time.
It refills completely when you die. It's actually more forgiving than I thought. Yeah, these games are really forgiving for arcade games.
Yeah, we have not once had to put in an extra quarter. Fuck.
Well, also in this version, you can't.
Right, but it wasn't even...
Yeah.
It hasn't even killed us.
I don't know if it had continues in the original arcade version. In general, we've not been grabbing the original arcade versions of these because the ones that I played were the Master System ones, and they're kind of...
Are the original arcade versions even on the...
Sometimes they are, sometimes they aren't. There's a secret right somewhere around there, just a little bit back. So just keep pressing up there. So yeah, you can buy... Oh, you can't buy the good shield. Buy the cheap shield.
Okay.
I don't even know what the difference between the shields is.
Oh, it's armor.
Oh, sorry. That's why there are different ones. Well, stuff will damage you less now.
That's good.
Also, you've got matching pink.
Woo.
I make a good sponsor. Oh, okay, my mistake. Monster World 3 is the one that got adapted. Monster World 3 apparently is the one that was Dynastic Hero. This one was turned into Bikuriman World. Yeah, this is the most convoluted series in video games.
Oh yeah, you get no continued in the home version. Jeez. It's brutal.
roguelike style.
I feel like it's really unfair that it keeps a timer from the arcade, but not the...
Yeah. It also has a maze at some point that apparently is impossible, but I can't actually get there, even on a good run. Or I may have just gotten there and gotten confused. I'm gonna run with a sack of money here. So in this one, holding attack doesn't change your jump.
Nope. It really has nothing to do with the other game, does it?
Yeah, no, it's...
Like, it's not even really the same... Was it called Wonder Boy in Japan?
I believe it was. Like, this is... I think we might be just getting just a slight delay, like a single frame delay.
Well, it's better than 8 frames.
Oh, yeah. No, just I'm pretty sure I hit that at the right time to hit him. Muscle memory wise.
In Japan, it had super in front of both, but not. Do you want to grab boots?
No, I'm not going to grab boots. I'm going to grab a. I'm just checking for secrets because I know that some of those, if you jump off of them. See, there's examples of, like, there's weird loot items in this that are just for score. Be in Lego Town. I don't know what the difference between the shields is, because, like...
Apparently...
Does somebody know?
Apparently the first one's fine.
Because, like, they're not bigger or anything like that, which would be the thing that I'd expect to make a difference. And as far as I can tell, I block all types of objects. What?
That fucking water.
Oh, it's gonna get weirder next week. Wait for the other Monster World or Monster. The other Wonder Boy 3 that we'll be playing next week. Its treatment of water just doubles down on that in a really great way. Yeah, I feel like if you thought the caves were ugly in the last one. This is some serious ugly cave.
I feel like this honestly reads better.
I disagree.
Like,
I think 8x8 repeating textures just make me angry.
Yeah, but I don't know. That cave was so ugly, whereas this is just wallpaper.
So this is the start of the chain for the side quest. The hero's emblem may help you to beat it. My friend Catherine lives in the coastal town of Barabos. Barabos. Give this letter to her. I'm just because I'm going to try to chain it, I want to point it out. So this is also, this is the inventory screen for it. So it, like, legit has a full inventory, even though it's an arcade game. I think in the arcade version, it shows up... on screen at the top, or the top bar is on the side. It's like a slightly different layout, since there wasn't a pause button. Oh shit.
That's real rough.
So yeah, this boss is a little bit easier with a shield.
Yeah.
Not much easier though, honestly.
Let me get closer.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do an interesting thing where at the very start they give you, like, every shop at once, you know, like, what kinds of shops there are, then afterwards they're all, like, sort of sparsely spread out.
Also gives you sort of a choice of, like, what is the one thing you want to upgrade at the start of the game.
Yeah. But it's also just so you, like, you know what to expect.
Just get the best shoes I can. Without backtracking. Weird squaw item. Yes, I can get the best shoes I can. Leather boots. Look at those muddy, ugly-looking leather boots. Let's see if I can afford to heal. Oh, almost. Damn. I might backtrack a bit.
You still don't have your potion, though.
Yeah, but I want to keep that for later if I can. I know there's coins somewhere here. There.
Shenanigans.
Shenanigans that will heal me. This definitely has the action RPG thing of, like, the farther into the game you get, the better it feels to play because the tuning is super slow. And weak early on. Which I don't mind. Oh, shit!
It was all for naught.
I don't mind in a short game like this. The longer a game is, the more annoying that you're slow and shitty to play with. I guess it's also sort of especially bad in platformers where a game feels so important.
Chad's asking which is the best to play. You should skip this game entirely and go straight to Monster World 4.
Yeah, Monster World 4 I think I might suggest that we do like a full stream of, because it's
really
so good.
It's actually good.
Yeah, a lot of these were sort of good for their time, but it's still both game development and the creator getting, like,
yeah,
figuring out what works. Like, this is also, like, one of the first action RPGs. And possibly the first side-scrolling one. I'm not sure, like, where does this compare to Zelda 2?
Yeah, that's a good question. Let me look.
Because definitely this and Zelda 2 were the most prominent.
Yep. 1988 for this.
Now these are just gonna give me fucking points anyways. What's the point? Fuck you, ghosts. This one's when?
This is 1988. And The Adventure of Link was 1987. So once again, they're just completely beaten to the punch.
Yeah.
Although, I will say, this is much more accessible than Wizardry.
No, and definitely, like... Oh, okay. So there's actually two of these that I would recommend playing. This one and the one we'll be starting with next week, which is the one that was an early Metroidvania.
Just play 4. Just play 4. Just skip straight to 4.
I've not played the good 3 in years, but I remember it being quite a good game.
On the other hand, 4 is,
four is
incredibly
fantastic.
Endearing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they each also do really different things. Like,
if
one
you're
is a Metroid.
Play 1, just play 4.
Yeah. If you're gonna play 2,
play 4 first and then.
And then play 3. Or wait for the really cool-looking remake of 3 that's being worked on. Do I have enough? Oh, I don't. Don't get what you can. Yeah, there are currently 3 Wonder Boy games.
Faxanadu was also 1987. I feel like saying that Faxanadu is better than anything is a very strong statement. I'm not sure.
Always check for secrets. Oh, fuck you, Knight. You're way too bouncy. Isn't that armor heavy?
No, it's pink. Oh, there's no coin. There's no key this time.
Yeah. I'm not totally clear on what the rules around that are. I think the ones that are just a weapon tend to be optional.
This thing where it changes the direction that you go in is such a very weird thing. Like, this is breaking such a huge game design rule. Sometimes you go- mostly you go right, sometimes you go left!
So here's an interesting thing, I can travel along the bottom here, and it's actually a lot easier. And here's where I wish I had some bombs, because it's useful for these guys. But along the top, it's full of secret sacks of money. So the top route is harder, but gets you more money.
That water, it's not instant death.
Yeah, I can walk
You can just
it.
Walk in it.
Yeah, it's shallow. Also, these fucking crabs with their bubbles. At least this time I've got... Oh. Some of the enemies I've figured out the trick to. Apparently slow-moving crabs are not one of them.
You have lightning.
Yeah.
Real lightning.
We'll probably save it for a boss. Fuck you, troll platform. So this is the town that they mentioned in the side quest. Also, these guys, the trick to them is hit, and then while they're in their stun thing, walk past. Also, I don't want any of those yet. And that's the secret door. I'm Catherine, looking for the emblem? Take this flute and visit Pororo Island. An old man living in a mysterious mansion will show you how to obtain it. Okay, I definitely need a hospital. Oh man, inflation. Can I afford a better... That's better than what I have, but if I can just kill enough things in this area... Let me see if I can kill enough of these fuckers. Oh, fuck off.
Nope, they just drop harps.
Let me see if there's a sack of money on this. Oh!
Still not enough.
Yeah, maybe if I kill the one up there, he'll give me... No, fucking hard. I'll try jumping off here.
You're gonna die. Gonna die.
I'm gonna buy the cheap one, even though I'm only 20 away. Check that out. All in weird sort of lime green.
Looking classy.
Oh, you. Oh! Huh. Oh, fuck off.
Yep, that would have been enough.
God damn it.
Well, now you know. And knowing is half the battle.
Oh, secret! Shit, I totally didn't find this last time I played. Okay, so they start doing that in this one.
You should really just run past them.
But I got a helmet. Which is probably...
But not like a real helmet.
No. What are you, crazy? That's a points helmet. It counts my hero points.
Real heroes grab every helmet they can find and just carry them around. Presumably in some sort of sack.
I do like how, like, while this game is super limited, they did manage to sort of get the sense of, like, things could be anywhere, or, like, there's all sorts of little hidden...
Things could be anywhere. It might not make any sense, but they could definitely be anywhere.
Squid!
But it's on land.
It's a land squid that flies. Don't judge. I used my magic once.
I feel like really bad. I feel like all these games have a problem where the boss doesn't tell you, like, if you've hit the boss.
Oh, the sound tells me?
It's so...
its little gem goes red each time.
That is such a bad... It's not enough. It's not nearly enough.
Oh, I agree. But we're still in the caveman art era of game design at this point. Yay, Cyclone. Oh yeah. Somebody mentioned you can fight that boss a second time if you go back in. Mm. This is where you really are glad you've got a shield.
Yeah,
I did
that
a
would
run
be,
where I didn't get a shield and got
shield.
Other stuff, and I was like super good at everything else, but this was just a fucking pain in the ass. I'm being a bit too aggressive. Also, I'm not jumping around these trees enough.
There is no way that you would know.
You start to sort of learn how the game designer thinks. Like, it's a way that you sort of, in Mario, start to learn what blocks you might want to try hitting under to find goodies in. Apparently, there are narrower trigger points in this version than they are in the arcade game. But I think damage may be less in this or something like that.
Is this Cyclone time?
Not yet. So these guys show up in four. They look totally different, but the same basic attack thing. Oh, someone didn't color in a pixel on them. Their outline's broken.
Oh, yeah.
Well, if Miyamoto can fuck that up on the clouds in Mario. Somewhere in here is a secret. I don't know where. I don't care.
Someone pointed this out in Super Mario Bros. 1. Bowser's fireball is pointing the wrong direction. They've never fixed this. In Super Mario Maker promo art, they have, like, huge banners that show Bowser doing a fireball going the wrong way.
That's crazy. Oh, whoops, I triggered a magic by mistake. The Mam Desert. Good old Mam Desert. Oh, I wonder if this is fucking terrible bit that I think we might be coming up to. Where there's a sand trap and I can end up stuck in there until I lose one of my lives.
Are you shitting me?
It's fucking... Fuck! That's where it is. I get a key, which I might need, I'm not sure.
Oh. I assume if you kill them all, you can jump back up.
Yes. It's a really hard series of jumps.
Yeah, this
seems like some
real bullshit.
Also, killing them is really hard. And unfortunately, this spell is not particularly useful.
Yeah, that won't actually help.
Okay.
You can do it. You probably can't do it.
I probably can't do it.
Oh, but you're gonna have to because you have a potion.
Yeah, I know. The potion will save me.
It'll bring you
back
to
life. This
is
why I wanted to make sure I had a potion.
This is cruel.
Yeah, no, it's super mean.
This time is slightly fair. I really, really hope it pushes you.
I'm just like, fuck these guys. Spells for them. Yeah, later games fix the, like, hit guy, then back up because they're gonna be impossible to hit. weird, like, stunlock pattern that this game is all about. Final boss of this game is actually a mecha dragon, which is important when we get to next week's games.
This is bullshit.
Fuck.
This is absolute bullshit.
Yes. Also, I'm playing terribly.
Oh, and here's a boss enemy.
Yeah. An easy one at least, but yeah.
The easiest, but still.
Shit. We'll see how far I get, stream. Man, I'm really glad this has a time limit. Yeah, I'm not getting that sack. Fuck that sack. Oh, shit. Oh, I bet there was a secret there. Yeah, this area is full of stuff that I'll miss because I don't know the best route. Oh, nice.
Damn, I'm just swimming in it.
Secret? Secret? No. No secret. Oh, fuck this thing! Now I can never get there. Aelomeed. This is also the first sign that the next game is going to be totally about furries. Oh! Oh, okay, so that was a hint that that was part of the quest chain, was to go there. But since I didn't I missed part of the quest chain. Oh, is that a different... Shit. Fucking die so I can keep playing. Oh, okay.
So... Oof. Let's move on to...
Yep, so now we're going to move on to... So the next game he made was another arcade game. This is sort of the last of the arcade games in the series.
And it's really a perfectly natural extension of everything we've seen thus far.
Yes. Yeah, so,
it makes perfect sense.
If you were to guess what comes after a wizardry-inspired platformer, after a caveman-inspired platformer, I'm betting you're guessing you ride dragons and it's a shmup.
Can you grab a...
Because guess what? You ride dragons and it's a shmup.
Do you want to explain the Japanese... Oh, you're getting into,
What?
You're passing me... You're passing me the other one.
Yeah.
I need to switch.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Wonder Boy in Monster.
I'm gonna grab some batteries for this.
Oh, there might be another one with more charge in it. Either way.
I'll just grab some batteries for it.
This one is called Wonder Boy 3 Monster Land. Which one is it? Wonder Boy 3 Monster's Lair. Not to be confused with what we're playing next week, which is Wonder Boy 3 the Dragon's Trap. Oh, so confusing. Wonder Monster in Boyland has not been made.
Yet.
Do you know how comprehensive the emulation of the Master System is on the Wii? I'm not sure.
Do you have it set to the different resolution?
Oh yeah, forgot. TurboGrafx, which does not emulate terribly well on the Wii. It's all blurry. There we go. So remember, this is all of these have been the same design art plan. All of these have been the same designer making these games.
And this auto-scrolls.
Yeah. So the auto-scrolling idea he had from the original.
Wait.
Yes! Okay, this game just suddenly became 10 times better. 13 times better.
Okay, Miguel, I'm gonna need you to not take all the fruit.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Don't worry, just blow up the fruit. So yeah, he eventually did get to make the Wonder Boy auto-scroller he wanted to.
Now I know what you're thinking. This makes absolutely no sense. Correct. Oh, that's why there's two paths.
Also, one of the best uses of beach balls as a melee attack. The other one being the Atari Lynx version of Gauntlet 3, which has beach balls near the end because they're apparently extra dangerous enemies. I'm so happy that he implemented that.
This is outstanding.
I think it's a general good co-op rule that if you can jump in a game, you should be able to stand on each other's heads. Yeah, you need to shoot backwards and blow it up so that...
Yeah, I know.
To our dragons!
Now you can fly, as one does. So one thing is that we do have a turbo attack button.
But it does weird stuff, and I don't know if that was part of the arcade.
It doesn't go all the way, is the thing.
We're playing the TurboGrafx, which I think was Turbo CD, so the music is extra good because we're extra good. Because it was a CD-ROM game. I love the design of this boss. Just great, weird, cute him up. His scales turn into little fishies that attack you.
So we went through that really quickly, but if you don't have a power-up on that, the way it has to work is that you can only use your regular attack because that'll only go far enough. But when it sends fish after you, you can't use your regular attack fast enough, so you have to use the turbo one. So it turns into sort of a balancing.
You figured out more of that than I did when I did my run.
I died a lot to it. Turns out this game, they didn't actually change the balance for two players. So it's very easy with two.
This, I think, feel like the first of the games that has something resembling modern game feel for the jumping and shooting and such. Oh, the stones that you can stumble over are back.
And we do still have stamina bars.
Yeah. See, in many ways, this is like a direct sequel to the first one. It is not, despite having the Monster's Lair in its name, it's not, I think, considered to be part of the Monster Land, Monster World series. It's only part of the Wonder Boy series. Except, oh wait, no, it's gonna have some stuff that's a throwback. I may be wrong. Hardest series to figure out what the hell is canon.
It's really only a sequel to the first one. I don't think it has any elements of that.
Wait, there's gonna be some visual stuff that will make you suddenly think of the, if we can get far.
But it's not mechanically.
Yeah, well, mechanically it's much more... It's like we just got, like, really good tomahawks. or Tomahawk missiles.
Oh, I think, like, it's mechanically, I can see where it comes from with the first, but it doesn't
yeah.
connect it to the world at all.
Yeah, there's going to be some connections coming up, from what I've looked into.
Oh, sorry, sure.
Oh, nice, when you jump, it throws me up. Yeah, no, there's a lot more, like, modern physics-y stuff in this. You can definitely tell it's 16-bit era and not 8-bit era anymore.
Also, there's absolutely no indicator of how long your attacks last for your special attacks. They go away after time, but I don't know how long or what it actually corresponds to at all. I think it's the number of uses, but it's not clear at all.
Yeah, it might be timer-based. I think I tried checking to see if I just wait a long time.
I think you can sit on them forever.
Yeah, no, it's a number of shots.
Yeah,
it's not
but it's
timer.
Not, it's completely okay.
Yeah, I kind of like the bosses in this. Like, they all have interesting... Like, they're not, like, super smart, but, like... It's fun to take out every part of the snake. Oh, are we turning invisible a lot for people?
That's weird, because your sprite isn't flickering.
It is when I get hit, and this flickering from... I think we're still getting some... Okay, the caves are back.
Yeah, this cave actually looks okay.
The
ground weapons, they also give you.
The concept of subdued palettes now exists. It took until we had 16 bits to figure that out. That scared me for a moment.
Yeah.
Yeah, the
even
co-op.
If you're playing single player. Oh, the boulders actually roll now.
Yep.
Even if you're playing single player, you still get, like, you still respond this way. It doesn't hurry back to the start of the level.
I like the co-op thing, the, like, health becomes more interesting. Because, yeah, I hadn't realized that we actually had to be, like, careful about who was grabbing.
Oh, shit. Fuck. I fucked up the timing on that.
We
were too far away from the big fruit. I really like that, actually.
The big fruit thing?
Yeah.
Or... Yeah, I like the big fruit thing. I also like the idea that we have to actually be paying attention about who's grabbing the fruit.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, you can't do the push down to jump thing.
No. No!
I wonder at what point he, starts, having, moving panels that actually are, like, synchronized in some way. Because there's a lot of just, like, all of the games have had a lot of these panels that are just sort of, like, doing their own thing next to other panels, doing their own thing.
No, huh, the TG-16 is actually still an 8-bit console,
it's a 16-bit graphic processor, with a, 8-bit main processor, I believe.
Well, I mean, you could still have, 16-bit integers as, colors, it's just no one did that because it would be, you know, like, you still definitely, like, access, like, 16-bit addresses on 8-bit, processors all the time. It's just...
But it did, like, it was a closer to the 16-bit consoles in terms of its abilities than to the 8-bit ones, at least graphically.
I mean, clearly you're seeing a lot more here.
Yeah. Oh, giant! Oh!
Oh,
nice!
No. Too many bats! Too many bats!
Shit. Oh, and it's slowly palette shifting to red to show me. how close it is to bed. So they figured out that the gem was too small.
But also, like, whenever you hit it, they flicker, which so important.
Yeah, no, there's a lot more feedback.
That white flash is really necessary.
And it shows you that hitting the head is important to hitting the other parts, isn't it? Tiring out my thumb. Did it! I wonder if it's a secret code that will get us infinite continues so we can just do the full one, because I don't think it's a terribly long game. Oh! So here is where I think we might start to get some. Oh, maybe not. What?
Oh, well, that makes sense.
Oh, I still have continues. Okay, separate continues, interesting.
Yeah. The turbo version of the shot works differently. I'm not sure how they actually pulled it off.
Yeah, it does it's often a shorter range.
Yeah, for the special attacks it's all the same, but for the regular one?
For some of the specials it's different too.
Oh really?
Yeah.
I assume probably what it does is that if there's like enough bullets on
happy
screen
foxes.
That you have to be pressing turbo, then it stops them from... But yeah, like your turbo version of the attack does not have the range.
I am very unclear what country this is supposed to be based in. Shit. Oh.
Okay. No.
What is it again? It's...
Left, right, down, up. Hold select to the left.
I'm not sure which one is select in this, in terms of...
Select.
Yeah, okay. No, I just mean if it was different.
I think it's still gonna be select.
Left, right, down, up.
Hold select, and then left.
Hold select, and left. Left, right, down, up. Select and left.
That was right.
I'm probably not the person to do this.
No, it's not doing anything. But it wasn't a great game.
No, it's... I think, like, the next game that we're starting with... Oh, we're not that late. We could... Oh. It wouldn't download. Because the Wii.
Yeah.
Hey, stream, do you want to watch me start to download the next number 3 in Wonder Boy and we can see if we can play it? Because it's actually not that late, so we can get into that so we have more time for the others.
I don't think it's going to work. I think probably it's all the same problem. I think we might as well just pack it in early.
Okay. What was the other one? When entering initials on the scoreboard, enter 68K, hold select. You'll have unlimited continues as long as you don't change it. Interesting.
Oh.
Okay. So yeah, those are the first three. And the next game is the one where I feel he really starts to hit his groove. And then he doesn't work on the one after that. And then we hit 4, which is, I think, kind of the masterpiece in... the series. Is this PCM sampled music at this point? I'm not sure. This is some pretty good music. So we didn't get to it, but at some point it basically has one of the towns from Wonder Boy in Monster Land. my god, this series.
It's confusing.
I feel like 9:30 is really early for us to be stopping.
We definitely usually go much longer.
You know what? Let's just staying in the weird Master System games, and because we'll never have a theme thing where it makes sense, let's do a bit of Alex Kidd. Because that game is strange.
I'll fire it up while you set the... The first Alex Kidd?
Yeah, that's the only one I have, because the other one's meh. Oh my god, there's so many of them. Alex Kidd in Shinobi World is like an adventure game. It's like, they did not stick to Alex Kidd BMX Trial?
Yeah, that sounds... We're looking at them and there's like a ton of...
Yeah, no. In Miracle World, there we go. Definitely, both Nintendo and Sega, like, and all of these developers didn't really... Didn't really care about sticking to a genre and being consistent with games at this point.
Yeah, no. Definitely Nintendo jumped around a lot, but they...
So yeah, you ever go first so you can experience it fresh with no knowledge.
I've never played this.
Look at all the things Alex Kidd can do. Oh, maybe it was High Tech World that was the adventure game one. I remember it being really arbitrary. Oh yeah, the jump is super strange.
So do you want to talk about how Alex Kidd was sort of a mascot?
Yeah, so like the two sort of mascot, closest things to a mascot for Sega at this point were Wonder Boy, which I believe they do own the character, even though it's not. Because it usually got reskinned when it ended up on other systems. So yeah, before Sonic, this was the best they could do. A kid with really big ears and a giant fist.
I mean...
Run!
Oh no!
Run!
He's supposed to be monkey, right? Like, that's the...
I think he's supposed to be kind of monkey-like. Yeah, we were talking about difficulty with these games before the stream. I've won the, like, Ninja Gaiden NES game, and I don't own an NES, and I never won this, and I owned it for years. Also, no continues. You gonna give it another try?
I'm gonna give it another try.
Yeah.
Because that was bullshit. It's gonna continue to be bullshit. Money is just points, isn't it? So there's no reason to fight anything, right?
Yeah, I don't think they give you gold. It's...
Yeah.
It's full of, like, weird memorization stuff, with, like, which things you should hit, which... Don't even try it. You don't want to get that skull. Don't run over that. It creates a skull monster.
Are you fucking shitting me?
Oh my god, it keeps
what?
Creating them. I didn't know that. I don't
this
think I ever
terrible.
Did that as a kid. It has the same, like, the idea of, like, just put a thing in front of you that does damage with
you
nothing
float.
Else done. Oh yeah, you float, so you've got to push
He's
down.
The opposite of Mario.
The thing that works like Mario swimming is the helicopter when you get it. You can't swim along the top there.
So, he can swim, but he can't walk. He can't wade.
Stay down, stay down. You want to get down to the bottom and just forward enough to hit with your attack.
I'm gonna be completely on level with you here. This is not a good video game.
No.
Are you fucking...
You want to get the onigiri that's hidden in that rock. That's the exit. The exits are always onigiri, which is really confusing as a kid. I was like, what are these weird white triangles with, like... And there he's eating the onigiri. No, we just ran out of the Wonder Boy games we planned to play for this period, so we thought we'd do a bonus.
Oh, so you can buy stuff.
Yeah. Buy the motorcycle. Always buy the motorcycle. I was always confused whether those were frogs or bighorn sheep. They're clearly frogs to me now, but on a CRT. I think you're gonna be coming up to the first boss.
Oh my
this
god,
game,
to fight a boss like this?
I'm actually not gonna say anything about the boss until we get to it.
Okay.
Because I want to see this.
I hate everything.
Yeah, stop and punch is a terrible...
It's really bad. It's extremely bad, and I can't believe...
It is at least you move faster than you do in the beginning of Wonder Boy, but like in neither one does it feel compelling. Oh! No. I thought it was just doing the same weird Wonder Boy, you hold down the button and you jump higher thing. What I'm also playing terribly.
The rings can be equipped from the pause screen. They let you shoot things from your fist.
That's what the deal is. Oh yeah, you've got an inventory. I forgot.
What?
Here, I'll do it now. Which is terrible because the pause screen required going over to the console. Oh, does it not work in water? Damn it.
Well, that was a waste.
Flicker before the money disappears. has a world map, shops. I would like to purchase this motorcycle. I am totally of age to drive it.
Yeah, I really don't, like, understand how this works.
What do you mean? How it works?
What does the motorcycle do?
It gives me an extra life, it goes fast.
But, like, what stops it?
Oh, it works like the skateboard in, Wonder Boy.
You're invincible when using it.
If I hit the red blocks, those are invincible. Because I can't punch through them either. I can punch through blue versions of them.
His ears are huge because he is, like, he's a monkey. I assume it's... Oh, I see. That blocks you from.
Yeah.
Well, if I assume the first boss, you totally want to fight the first boss.
I absolutely don't, but...
I also did not know what a Jenkin match was as a kid. So you gotta think about what you want to do. What do you want to play against him? Oh! You were turned to stone, because that's what happens when you lose a Jenkin
match.
Are
you shitting me? What?
I shit you not.
Is it just random?
There was a trick to it. Check a fact. Man, this is the weirdest jump physics. I'm trying to figure out... What? It's not linear. It's doing something. Okay, let me try using the ring now. Oh yeah. That's more like it.
Just in order, but it's terrible.
What's the deal? They just have an order? What about the next ones? Because I think they change.
It's one singular order for the whole thing, so.
For every boss, though?
Which this. No, it's not the same. It's one long string.
Oh.
You just have to remember.
So if you get it offset.
Yeah.
Oh, that's why it seemed random. That's crazy. And terrible. Also crazy.
Right. I mean, what it really is, it's just a random number generator seated the same way every time because, you know...
I think later, but I feel like later on there was a thing where you could see what they were going to do and you could sort of like trick them into second guessing. That was my childhood memory of how it worked.
Well, apparently that is not actually accurate.
Weird.
You were much nicer to the game designers than they deserved. Are you stuck?
No. Yeah, so that thing just doesn't work underwater. But when I get to that boss, I will ask you what the weird series is.
Oh my god.
We'll leave video games.
I don't know if this is early video games. I feel like this is...
No, they came worse than this. Like, I agree, this is not a good game.
I feel like what I'm learning here is that the Master System fucking sucked.
This is also true. With the exception of the next Wonder Boy we're going to be playing and Phantasy Star, pretty much. Fuck you, Ghost. I thought he was drinking a beer there at one point as a kid. It sort of looks like foamy. Oh yeah, okay, let's get everything. What's the mystery box got?
What's in the box?
Had the better version of Double Dragon.
Apparently Aladdin wasn't bad. Okay. Wait, Master System version of Aladdin?
Yeah, oh, a lot of stuff got...
Different from the Genesis version. Alright. Huh. Phantasy Star 1 is really, really fucking hard. It's just super grindy. Frankly...
So that was, like, that was the time.
Way more so than Final Fantasy 1 is.
Okay. I've only
And
played
Final Fantasy
this.
1 is some...
But did it have
it's
a flying cat?
Either.
See, that's the tiebreaker for me. One had a flying cat in your party. Spoilers.
Damn.
Like, you can't beat that, I'm sorry.
It's true. There's no flying cat in the...
Take this pile of potatoes.
Until, I believe... Final Fantasy III is the one that introduces the kind of wizard that has a cat ear robe, which is extremely cute.
But also, like, when did Final Fantasy start actually having characters?
The second one.
Okay.
But everyone hates the second one. Like, it is universally considered to be complete garbage.
Also, like, rare female protagonist in Phantasy Star. And woman game designer behind it as well, I believe.
Really?
Okay, what do I need to do first to beat Stonehead?
You need to throw rock.
I believe it gets uneaten. It's been, like, about... when did that game come out? It's been since then, since I played it.
A while. Okay, first rock, then scissors.
Okay, first rock, then scissors. I used to actually have this shit memorized.
That was apparently how you're expected to do it. Good old rock. Nothing beats rock.
Ha! Then scissors?
Yep.
Oh yeah, Dr. Mad. I wonder what that was translation of. I don't know what that is, so I'm not gonna risk it being a fucking ghost. Oh, get ready for some bullshit.
That's some real bullshit.
Why is it inside a fish tank? I should just swim past that one.
You should absolutely do that.
Yeah.
Oh, his pajamas flash colors when he's
invincible.
That's cool.
Fuck seahorses.
Man, I'm gonna be honest. If I got this for Christmas instead of Mario, I would assume that my parents didn't love me.
But it had more colors. Colors.
So, like, I feel like the NES definitely has, like, a lot of garbage first-party games. Like, or games that are, I feel like, very half-baked. But they're always revolving around, like, one idea. Like, Ice Climbers or, you know, Balloon Fight or all these weird, like, one-idea games. feel like it's way better than this ridiculous kitchen sink approach where nothing works.
Yeah, I don't know. I find the kitchen sink kind of like, yes, these games are terrible, but they're kind of interestingly terrible because of the strange things that they did.
I feel like I'd rather be playing Ice Climbers. And that's a strong statement.
I've never played Ice Climbers.
It's not much. Really? It was in Animal Crossing.
I watched my housemates play Animal Crossing when it first came out.
Why don't you have your own since. In their town? That's like the whole... Oh.
Destructible terrain.
That was like the cool thing about the original Animal Crossing was that, you know, everyone could have...
Yeah, no, I just didn't get into it. I think it's my general dislike of grindiness, and it seemed at the time like a game with a lot of grind. I watched my housemate shake a lot of trees. Or whatever it is you do to the trees, I think it's shaking.
Yeah, you shake them.
I don't know why that vine is coming out of the lava. I think that's an interesting aesthetic choice.
Is Faxanadu really interesting, though? It's...
What I'd say...
I don't know if that's true.
Oh, shit. What I'd say about the weird, like, all-over-the-placeness of these games is... As an adult and a game designer, I'm like, this is some terrible, like, random throw-it-at-the-wall garbage with a few interesting ideas in it, and oh my god, I'm having a seizure. But as a kid, being able to do all this different stuff was exciting. And all video games were impossible to beat. So, the fact that, like, the graphics were a bit shinier and prettier, and instead of just shooting at ducks in Duck Hunt, I was shooting at panthers and other stuff in their shooting game with the light gun. That shit mattered as a kid with no taste. Let's see, I think this will show some of the stuff that we weren't able to get to with... Oh, there's the level I died on.
They're really not doing a good job of making this look interesting.
Yeah, no, like that jump and try to hit a thing in the air at the right time is such a bad... loop.
Yeah.
Come on, show the speedboat of the helicopter. Show us the helicopter. There we go. So this, yeah, you're pushing a button to pedal up. Also, you can shoot.
Like, there's just no coherent idea at the core of this game at all.
You're Alex Kidd and you like to drive things, anything. Motorcycles, pedal copters, racing boats. Also, you like onigiri. And apparently there's bosses with different hands.
Yeah, well,
okay, yeah, no, it makes no sense.
I don't know, at least like the skateboard was challenging, but this is just like annoying. Like there's no reason to just plow through everything, you might as well just like jump over.
It's a lot faster is the main
everything.
Thing. Oh yeah, no, like you could try to get the coins. Okay, they made a bunch of these games, do they get better? Here's the thing, none of them are the same. They're completely, completely different games. Like, they change the size. Even the ones that are still, like, action platformers, they change the, like, overall aesthetics massively. They change the size of the sprites and the size of the world you're exploring.
One's like an adventure game.
Yeah, they're
a
all
shitty
over
adventure
the place.
Game.
This is probably actually the best of them.
That's rough.
I think at least one of them was a card game, which was never a good sign, as I mentioned earlier. There's some other ones that I'm curious about. There was one that I think was trying to go for, like, the Zelda 2 thing called, I think, it's not Last Stand, that's another game on it, but it was another R word, and you were a dude wandering around with, like, a sword, and...
Well, shall I pack it in for...
Yeah, let's pack it in. So, yeah, next week we'll be seeing...
Actually, good games.
Seeing more Seaman, and we're going to be hitting the...
Also Seaman.
The high points of the Wonder Boy series, and the one the main designer didn't work on, which is... Looks like it's a move up, but is actually kind of a move down from what I've seen so far. I haven't played super far into it.
Okay.
But we're going to get to be a dragon.
Woo.
And maybe a mouse man and a fish man, depending on how far we get in the other Wonder Boy 3.
Speaking of card games, how's Metal Gear Acid? Not as interesting as you'd hope. I feel like the card game aspect never really quite comes together. And it's actually less weird than normal Metal Gear, which is unfortunate.
I want to be
not
a dragon.
Not for lack of trying, but...
Yeah, an important thing to remember is that if we had somehow magically been good enough to do it on a single life in the first Monster Land that we played, the very end of that, you're fighting a mecha dragon. The very beginning of the next game we're going to be playing continues right off of that with you fighting that mecha dragon.
Cool.
Which might be the first time that was done in a sequel, I'm
not
sure.
Cool. Anyway, thanks everyone for joining us.
Yep, thanks.